it's so clear to me that the hardest choice and the scariest choice is always the choice that saves you. Sitting down and saying, I can't do this alone. That's why I'm still here today. My name is Katie Bergman. I am 18 years old, and I'm very excited to be a freshman next year at The Ohio State University. And I live with anxiety and have experienced depression, self-harm, and suicidal ideation. So for me, this all started where I think a lot of people's stories start, which is family. You know, my family was rocked by a very hostile divorce. I think that that's the pain that I carry with me. I think people carry certain instances of pain with them, and for me, my childhood and my parents' divorce, that's the pain I really carry with me. But it wasn't until really around the sixth grade when that pain I carried with me evolved into something more. It couldn't just be pinpointed to my childhood or pinpointed to something my parents experienced. It really was something that was totally new. You know, depression numbed me, but anxiety made me fear that numbness. It felt slow, but all at once, the way that depression and anxiety hit me, it felt, you know, like I slowly retracted from my life. I slowly kind of left my body and was just this shell, really. But at the same time, you know, it hit me like a ton of bricks that the people I loved and the things that I valued, I no longer could invest myself in fully. And that pain of not being present, it rattled me. It shook me, and I didn't know how to process it. And everything just felt deeper and bigger and worse, almost. Even the happy moments felt wrong in my body. Joy and laughter felt foreign to me, which, looking back, you know, I wasn't an unhappy kid. I was bubbly. I was the straight A student. I was involved in everything. I was friends with everybody. I could sit at any lunch table. That was my reality.